It's time for another trip on the recruiting trail as we hit the road to meet some of the nation's best prospects. This week, we're stopping in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania to meet Kyle McCord of St. Joseph's Prep. 2020 has taken many athletes at all levels on an emotional roller coaster this year. Kyle McCord and his teammates at St. Joe's Prep are no different. From having their season in doubt, then having it postponed, then having it restarted with a limited number of opponents, the Hawks are doing the best they can to stay ready for whatever is next.
On a normal year, we'd start practice the first day in June, and obviously this year we got pushed back, didn't get the green light to go until really August. It's something that we've never experienced, but I think our coaches have done a great job handling it and putting the players in the best position to first stay healthy and then succeed on the field.
You know, I try to tell the kids to focus on just trying to find ways to get better every day. You know, let me handle all that stress of, you know, going through all the logistical things and show up every day, whether it's on a Zoom call or out here on the field with your coach, and how we manage that is important because we don't want to lose focus on continuing to find ways to get better.
As of right now, honestly, it's just getting better day by day and focusing on ourselves, especially when you don't know who your opponent is. I think the biggest thing is to really look in the mirror and get better every day and focus on yourself as a team.
Kyle is one of the highest rated quarterbacks in the country, and he's learned a lot from his father, Derek. The elder McCord played quarterback at Rutgers, and he's been working with Kyle since he was old enough to hold a football.
Yeah, my dad has been huge in every part of my life, really since day one. He's had me taking three-step, five-step drops in the backyard at 5 years old. He's definitely helped me to get to this point. I wouldn't be here without him.
Derek has done a phenomenal job of, especially from a quarterback position, right, be able to groom his son into understanding those drops, understanding scheme, understanding just how to be able to control yourself at that position. And he has that sense of calmness and that calm, cool, collected attitude and that confidence, though, that he's going to get things done. There's not many quarterbacks his age that have a command of the football the way he does. You know, his power, his accuracy, he has a sense to be able to get out of the pocket and hurt you with his arm and his legs, which I think goes a little unknown, but, you know, we obviously don't want him running around all the time, but he can make that happen as well.
Mostly a pocket passer, as that's what they say in most of the recruiting sites, but I'm able to get outside the pocket, make plays with my feet, and beat the defense with my head, making smart plays and always trying to get the ball in my playmaker's hands. That's probably the biggest part of my game, and I'd definitely say I'm a little bit of an underrated outside the pocket.
Kyle's recruitment got started pretty early. He began receiving scholarship offers as an eighth grader, and he's been committed to Ohio State since the spring of his sophomore year.
It was really a no-brainer going to Ohio State. I committed in April of my sophomore year. And I liked a lot of other schools. I like Penn State, I like Clemson, I like Stanford. But when it really got down to it, it was an easy decision for me. And they just recruited me the hardest, and I felt like I'd have the best chance to succeed in Columbus.
This year's St. Joe's Prep team is one of the most talented in program history. Kyle and two of his teammates, Marvin Harrison Jr. and Jeremiah Trotter Jr., have been selected to the All-American Bowl roster, although that game, unfortunately, won't be played this year. So Kyle and his teammates will just focus on winning as many games as they can this fall. And then Kyle is planning to graduate in December and enroll early at Ohio State.
Main thing right now, I just want to finish out my senior year on the right note. Just inching to get back out there in the field with my brothers and finish out the season, like I said, undefeated, and if we get the shot for a state championship. And then once I get to Ohio State, just put my head down and work. Obviously, there's gonna be a lot of competition out there, but I think it's gonna be a lot of iron sharpening iron out there for sure.
Assuming Justin Fields heads to the NFL, the Buckeyes will be looking to figure out their 2021 starter this spring, and Kyle will show up ready to compete. Thanks for checking out Sports Stars of Tomorrow on YouTube. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to give it a like, and please subscribe to our channel so you see all of the latest content.